ended in heartbreaking disappointment, but it was arguably the greatest season in the club's history. The 96-97 campaign certainly provided Boro fans with an unprecedented level of drama and worldwide recognition. Fabrizio Ravanelli, a £7 million signing from Juventus, was the Premiership's top goalscorer and almost fired Boro to victory in their first major cup final at Wembley after 121 years of trying. Flamboyant Brazilian star Emerson proved the pundits wrong, overcoming his homesickness and sending Boro on their way back to Wembley in style in the FA Cup with a memorable strike against Chesterfield. The darling of the fans was Juninho, the undisputed player of the year, a dazzling superstar who served up so many moments of breathtaking football. As well as scoring goals, Juninho was the creator. One of his finest displays inspired Boro to their sweetest victory of the season against Newcastle. Frustratingly, Brian Robson's men finished runners-up in both cup competitions, and the controversial deduction of 3 points cost Boro their place in the Premiership. But the club united on a moving return to Teesside when the fans responded like never before in an incredible show of support for the Boro.
To give us the support that they've given us, you know, especially when we've been in the bad times, to me that's true supporters, because it's easy to support your team when you're being successful in that. It's when you're having a bad run that is when you need your supporters more than ever. And our fans have been top class as far as that's concerned. They've never sort of got on the backs of the players. They've always encouraged them no matter what the performance or the results have been in the home matches.
If you're involved at the professional level the way that I am, then you have an automatic optimism. And I'd have guessed that 11 years ago, I would have hoped that it didn't take 11 years to get there. Now that it has, we've enjoyed the occasion of the Cup final and we want more of them. So we don't really analyse where we've come from. We analyse where we are and where we need to be and where we want to be. And the lessons that we've learnt this season have been many. And the important thing, and I keep on stressing it, is it's easy to learn lessons. It's difficult to implement the changes. And we've got to implement the changes at this club. We have to be ruthless in the way we implement them changes.
A remarkable season began in dramatic fashion on the opening day, when Ravanelli made his debut against Liverpool. Also making his high-profile debut was Emerson, Boro's £4 million signing from Porto. Emerson and Ravanelli totalling an £11 million investment by the Boro, itself a proud achievement by chairman Steve Gibson.
Mark Wright to take it.
In the Middlesbrough script, Curtis Fleming galloping down that left touchline in support, back to Juninho. Mark Wright's come out to confront him. Juninho, oh, must be a penalty. Liverpool in furious protest, but it's a penalty and it's a yellow card, I think possibly for McManaman. It's not immediately clear, and the ball to be placed on the penalty spot by Fabrizio Ravanelli, this to open his account in English football. Ravanelli gets his first goal, courtesy of the penalty. It's one apiece, and the Italian winding up the crowd. The white feather signals his arrival on Teesside. Collymore holding off Pearson. Here's McAteer. John Barnes, beautifully done by Barnes. Wonderful goal. Absolutely magnificent. Middlesbrough trying to keep the pressure on. It's a pressure cooker atmosphere. Here's Cox. Into the 6-yard box, Ravanelli! Well, he may earn himself a rebuke from the FA, because you're not actually supposed to bare your chest in the Premiership this season. But Ravanelli, unable to resist his customary salute to a goal. 35 minutes gone, he gets his second on his Premiership debut, and it's 2-2.
Michael Thomas on it first. Bjornaby can try again. Janino, crowd shouting to warn him that McManaman was arriving. Here's Musto trying to burst through. Ravanelli, yes! It's a hat-trick. It's 3-3. David James on his backside had no chance with a ball which rolled agonisingly slowly past him.
I was really pleased with our attacking display today. We carved up a team like Liverpool quite a few times, where I felt a couple of the Liverpool goals were bad mistakes by my defenders, which we can work on that and we can improve on that. Mm. So that was the only disappointing aspect as far as I was concerned, you know, the goals we give away.
Good turn by Hughes, Petrescu, Viali. That was a wonderful save by the goalkeeper. Di Matteo!
Boro denied in their first away match by Ruud Gullit's Foreign Legion. Next stop was the City Ground, where Janino landed his first goal of the season to give Boro a 1-0 lead at the start of the second half. A great finish by the Brazilian, an early sign of greater things to come from the little fella. A wonderful goal and well worth a second look. It was a match that could have gone either way, but the final goal of the afternoon came from the boot of Stuart Pearce. A strike of typical venom by the Forest skipper. Pick that one out, as the saying goes. There's certainly no way anyone was going to stop that blockbuster. After three matches without a win, Boro's new blend finally got it right in the home match with West Ham.
Juninho. Now Emerson. Oh, it's a glorious goal! Emerson's first for Middlesbrough. A real thumper. Hit with venom and maybe a slight deflection from all of 30 yards. Barbie to Musto. From Dix, Ravanelli! Musto coughs, yes! 2-0. Ravanelli turning away from Julian Dix and rattling the frame with a goal. And I think Robbie Musto's header may have crossed the line before Neil Cox got to it. It did. It's Musto's goal. Now Juninho. In towards Ravanelli. 3-0. Between these two great players, and Middlesbrough's first victory of the season, definitely building. Ravanelli hails his fourth goal for the Borough, set up beautifully by Juninho. Dix couldn't get to Ravanelli. Ravanelli caught in possession by Michael Hughes. Michael Hughes has put West Ham United back in the frame with a wonderful goal. Ravanelli, Stamp to his right. This is Emerson. Now Phil Stamp. Holds off Dix and scores! Oh, what a moment for Phil Stamp. I think it's only his second touch of the ball. A goal conceived in Italy and Brazil and finished here.
Yes, I was pleased with our attacking play. You know, the movement and the passing was excellent tonight, and we could have scored a lot more goals. So, yeah, there was a lot of pleasing things come out from the performance tonight.
It's the start of an exciting run of form by Boro, and Robbo's men round off a perfect week in similar fashion against Coventry City.
Barmby at the far post.
They didn't pick him up, and Middlesbrough take
into this game, overcomes the cross, Ravanelli, well, they could have, two of them could have got that ball, Emerson was there as well, but Ravanelli gets the touch, his fifth goal in the Premiership. Barmby, Mosto's got space, Shaw's the man between him and the goal, Juninho, 2-0. Shaw's the man behind him preventing the shot, and a great little ball here from Musto to Juninho, who slides it in beautifully past Grizovic. Oh, well won by Musto. Ravanelli tries the shot, what a goal! He bended in around him, super shot from City by 3-0. Nice ball to Juninho. Ravanelli, the man in front of him, pulling to the right now. Here it is to Ravanelli. Is he on for a hat-trick here? It's on the left foot. Slits it through. The flag stays down. It must be! Juninho! 4-0. Ravanelli sets up Juninho.
Like I said, we've played very entertaining football all season, all five games, and I mean the crowd love it. I mean you go around in the town, and you know they're really happy what they're seeing. And I mean personally for me as well, to watch, obviously I have to concentrate on the game, but to watch the football that's being played is very exciting for everybody involved with the club.
Hinchcliffe. Craig Short is the scorer. Bambi, it looked as though he might have been offside, but no flag. And Middlesbrough are back at 1-1. No protest. So simply a question of Everton going to sleep. Nick Bambi's first goal for Middlesbrough this season. It is Ferguson, and that is a brilliant save. And if he was at fault on the first goal, then in my opinion he was, certainly denied Everton going ahead again. Gone completely away from his mark. It was a good header and a really good chip over. Bambi, English combination, Juninho! What a dispatch! And it's Samba time for Middlesbrough, whose comeback in the second half has delighted their supporters.
There's always a danger that you take the sort of smaller clubs a bit too lightly, but I don't see that as a problem tonight. I think the players look as though they're up for the game, and it's the first step on the ladder to a Wembley appearance, and I think that's the way you've got to look at these things.
Juninho still going, Ravanelli's got space, he had to check, he just steers it in, and Ravanelli on the mark again. Emerson tries one. Musto to Ravanelli. Ravanelli, it's three! Here he goes again. Juninho on the outside. And Ravanelli, hat-trick! Absolutely inevitable. That's his second hat-trick in four home games. Ravanelli away again. Still he's got it. Juninho in the middle.
it's emphatic. It's a fourth for Fabrizio Ravanelli.
After 17 goals and four straight wins, the bubble finally burst in the home match with Arsenal. Nick Barmby is recalled after missing the Hereford match.
Martin Bonham from Cornwall. A long, long ball from Lee Dixon. Chance here to make it 1-0. Oh, and it's gone in. Superb goal. How about that? Arsenal the scorer. And he's going to have a go at goal. Oh, what a shot. Hit the post. Oh, came off the post. A thunderous effort there from Ravanelli. And that up against England's goalkeeper. He beat the keeper all ends up, but couldn't get it inside the woodwork. So unlucky. Given away by Cox. This is Merson. Right to his left. Looks for Ian Wright. Oh, oh, and Ian Wright's in. It must be 2-0. Another error by the Boro players. Not a bad ball. Barmby lost his balance there. This is Emerson. Oh, no. Ravanelli! Chance here! Oh, he's hit the post! Ravanelli hits the woodwork for the second time of the game. And Ravanelli throws his shirt to the floor in disgust. Well, the way he worked the opening was absolutely brilliant. He held off two challengers there and seemed to have turned the ball in on the goal here. Emerson, clever little bit of play. Juninho with a shot. Oh, a stinging shot from Juninho from 25 yards. And David Seaman gets a hand to it and turns it around.
That's the end of Boro's unbeaten home record. Brian Robson makes seven changes for the Coca-Cola Cup return leg with Hereford. The tie is already in the bag after winning the first leg 7-0. And Mikhail Beck celebrates his long-awaited debut with the opening goal midway through the first half. Beck quickly putting behind him his 5-month freedom of contract battle with his former club Fortuna Cologne. A corner by Branco paved the way for goal number 2 at the start of the second half. Phil Stamp put his seal on the match with an unstoppable drive, his second goal of the season. 2 minutes later, another Branco corner catches out the third division side. This time the Brazilian's kick crosses the line without getting a touch. Hereford well and truly out for the count. Boro's 10-0 aggregate win is an impressive start to the Coca-Cola Cup campaign. Frustratingly, Boro's league form has deserted them, and nothing goes right at the Dell, where the Saints took the lead inside 12 minutes. Matthew Oakley claimed the opening goal after Miller had blocked Magilton's initial effort. Then came a match-winning double for Matt Letizier. An in-swinging corner caught everyone out. An inspirational midfielder's kick sailed past Miller, Letizier, the master of the unexpected. With half an hour gone, Southampton led 2-0, but Boro should have pulled a goal back before half-time. Good work by Nick Barmby opened up the Saints and teed up Ravanelli for the kill, but a super goal-line clearance denied the Italian. Another superb Matt finish wrapped up the points early in the second half, when Simon Charlton teed up Letizier's second. Boro's defence nowhere to be seen. Miller had no chance. Gordon Watson completed the demolition job in the 82nd minute when he added goal number 4. Alan Miller this time exposed by an error by Derek White. Boro's misery was complete when the penalty 4 minutes from time offered the chance of a consolation. But Ravanelli shot wide and Boro are beaten by 4-0. October begins with a farewell to John Hendry. Meanwhile, Boro attempt to end their losing sequence at Roker Park.
Ravanelli. It's a lovely ball. Fleming on the left. Emerson with the shot. Oh! What a goal! Kubicki with a long ball looking for Stewart. A great cry for handball from the home supporter. Whelan can't believe it, but penalty it is.
Well, Whelan's already been booked, and well, the referee sent him off. I mean, once again, that's a really harsh decision. I mean, he's been booked for a harsh decision. Now he gives away a penalty. He can't believe it. I can't believe it.
So, it's Ball, the captain, and it's a goal. Alex Ray from the penalty spot brings Sunderland level.
Terrific block on the line.
Houghton hesitates again, and once more Ravanelli, yes! He's got it! Slides it in for Stewart. Stewart on to Gray. It's a good tackle by Pearson. But suddenly, Ball comes to get it back again.
Robbie Musto and Derek White return for the home match with Spurs.
Sheringham goes for goal. Oh, and he scored! Beats Alan Miller. Oh, and that was a bad mistake by the goalkeeper. Got a pass from there. Oh, Fox! Two goals in a minute. And Raul Fox heads Spurs into a two-goal lead. Good cross in, 3-0! Sheringham the scorer, beautiful run by Carr, perfect cross, and it's all over for Boro.
Early confirmation that Brian Robson has a defensive problem to tackle. With Alan Miller soon on his way, Gary Walsh takes over against First Division Huddersfield.
Beck, Cheninho, all the way! A beauty! Emerson. Plenty of possession. Emerson shot! Oh, I say! It's an absolute thumper. And here he is now trying to make amends in the best way he knows how. Tries the bender! And it's looped in with a deflection, and that does make amends. Forward by Musto. Cheninho took it down, Emerson took control, played it straight to Ravanelli, the goalkeeper's come out, and he's made it easy. Trying to flick it through for Moore, got there, now Beck, and he's got his goal. Good finish. So, Denmark add their name to the scoreline. Referee wave play on, Edwards keeps it going, Payton. Well, they've got something.
Through to round four of the Coca-Cola Cup, Boro returned to league duty against high-flying Wimbledon.
Good spell for Middlesbrough. Pearson. Cox. Goalkeeper stays in his line. Chance for Beck. Off the post. Ravanelli. Cheninho. Towards Ravanelli, punched away bravely by Sullivan, drops to Stamp. Stamp's effort, off the post, how unlucky can you get?
So Boro deny the Dons a record equaling 8th successive win. But it's a costly point for the Boro. Skipper Nigel Pearson ended up in hospital and he faces a long layoff with a neck injury. Meanwhile, it's goodbye to Nick Barmby. Just 14 months after arriving on Teesside, he's on his way to Goodison Park in a £5.75 million deal that makes him Everton's record signing. Next stop is St James's Park for the first encounter of the season with arch-rivals Newcastle.
It's Beardsley! From the bench, but also the reaction from Gary Walsh thrusting up an arm. Lee. Oh, Rob Lee will be happy to claim that one. Cheninho and Beck. Oh, he's hit the bar when it seemed a formality to get a goal for Middlesbrough at St James's Park. But now that's a Stamp's ball and a goal for Beck, and they have been opened up. It's not a clean sheet.
Mikhail Beck's late reply is his first goal in the Premiership, but it's too little too late. Matters aren't helped when Emerson suffers a bout of homesickness. and the prophets of doom queue up to write off Robbo's Riverside Revolution. Boro insist Emerson will be staying. Meanwhile, the Brazilian misses a couple of matches, starting at the baseball ground.
And Ward crosses Asanovic. 1-0 to Derby. Well, the Croatian. Free kick. Oh, what is a great ball. It's an own goal.
Well, Ward's clean. Steve Vickers.
Ravanelli's got a free header, and Middlesbrough will feel perhaps the tide is starting to turn.
A battling display by Boro, full of pride and passion. When things aren't going your way, it's hard to break the sequence. But Boro continue to show their fighting spirit against defending champions Manchester United.
This is Beckham. And Keane, oh, classic goal. Clegg. Musto, Janino, Ravanelli begins his run. And here is Ravanelli, Schmeichel's out, and Ravanelli scored. The Riverside stands as one to salute the local hero, whose 15th goal of the season has put the Borough back on terms. Janino set it up, but what about Schmeichel? He came herring out of his goal, and the ball, not for the first time in recent weeks, went right underneath him. Beckham. And it's in. Janino standing over the ball. Beck appeals for handball, it's a penalty. And Manchester United are furious. Well, there was the free kick, and it was Paul Scholes who's been penalised for handball. Craig Hignett will take the kick and will find the equaliser for Middlesbrough.
Battling Boro came close to snatching all 3 points, but the harsh reality is they've now gone 8 matches without a Premiership win. League form is forgotten in the Coca-Cola Cup showdown with Newcastle. Emerson is back in the starting lineup and helps inspire a night to remember.
Well, here he comes again, and Ravanelli is screaming for the ball, but in the end, Beck didn't want him. Well, Middlesbrough have a corner. In right footed, but gets up there, comes out to White. Derek White, Middlesbrough ahead. It's 27 minutes, that's his first goal for Middlesbrough this season, and he'd come up for the corner. Goodness me, the shot came in the end, and there he was, just at the right point. And even on the line, Gillespie couldn't keep it out. Into the last minute of the first half. Shearer's come up, Peacock's come up. Up goes Shearer. And he scored! Alan Shearer. Gillespie, his right-hand side, crosses it to Esprit, who turns brilliantly, and a lovely save. Gary Walsh had to get down quickly. A brilliant piece of skill from Tino Asprilla. Janino. Beck wide on this right-hand side. It's inside. Hignett. Chips one. Hits the crossbar. Senicek had no idea where that was going. It's a wonderful piece of skill. Emerson. Brilliant from Emerson. Janino. Ravanelli. Beck! It's two! A goal from almost nothing there. Wonderfully finished. And
And this is the man, Mikel Beck. He scored in every round. As I was saying earlier, hasn't been prolific as a scorer for Middlesbrough, but this ball from Ravanelli, he tucked home beautifully. Janino fought and battled his way through. Ravanelli, a first-time cross, and it's in the back of the net, and Boro are 2-1 in the lead. Ginola gets it, long way out, good save. And Walsh gets the rebound too. He's had a good game, Gary Walsh, made a couple of splendid saves. Stamp. Cross from Vickers, the right-hand side. This is how Middlesbrough want to be finishing this game. Janino. It's on the cross, Ravanelli! And Middlesbrough are in the last eight! And it's Janino who's fashioned the chance to put Ravanelli in. And there's his message. We're in the last eight. And kisses for you from me.
Sadly, Robbo's men can't repeat their cup form in the league at Villa Park. Emerson is still ruled out by suspension, and Neil Cox returns against his former club, only to concede the match-winning penalty. The ex-Villa man not happy to be penalised for alleged shirt-pulling on Dwight York just before half-time. In-form York took his chance to claim victory with his eighth goal in nine games. 1-0 to Villa, the final score. That's nine Premiership games without a win, and the run gets worse at home to Leicester City.
Lennon. Twisting, turning. Gets a good ball in. Claridge with the header. Claridge with the goal. It's 1-0 to Leicester City. Just before the break. A great psychological moment this. Marshall up on the penalty spot. Ravanelli tracking him back. Short, that wasn't a bad shot. Oh, what a goal! A superb effort! Well, my word!
Janino and Emerson both missed the home match with Leeds. Jan Argafjortoft is recalled.
Little with the throw. Fjortoft. Oh, that's a great shot from Fjortoft! Beautifully taken on the turn. And a marvellous save by Nigel Martin. Sure to have a go on goal, yes! Oh, superb shot, just over the top it went. Nigel Martin flying across there, I'm not sure whether he would have got it. And Middlesbrough convert here. Header from Stamp, oh! The fans at the far end thought that was in. That was so close. Phil Stamp, he scored twice this season already. Three goals for him in 35 league appearances.
Well, if that was a display full of heart, wasn't it?
Yes, bear in mind the people we've got missing today. You know, no Beck, no Emerson, no Janino, no Pearson, no Vickers. So it's pleasing. So I'm pleased for the players, I'm pleased for the bat lads, because they battled away and got themselves a point.
It's now 11 matches without a Premiership win for unlucky Boro, and the nightmare continues at Anfield, despite the return of Emerson.
Saying, well, the answer is barely 30. And he's got it all. Oh, is it the post, Fowler? Yes! It's 100 up for Robbie Fowler. It's the century of goals for Liverpool. Good save, Ripianov is there. It's in. Stigging, you better be following up. Fjortoft's there! Oh, it's crept in! Middlesbrough have got a goal! Fjortoft signals to the supporters and David James beaten down by the post. Oh, careless. This is McManaman. Fowler to his left! And Fowler's in here! And it's four! And it's the hat-trick for Robbie Fowler! This is Collymore to his right, Fowler.
Boro's mounting injury and illness nightmare reaches epidemic proportions on the eve of the trip to Blackburn. The club make the ill-fated decision to call off the game at Ewood Park and face the wrath of the Premier League. They'll have to wait to learn their punishment. Meanwhile, Boro have now gone over 3 months without a Premiership win. Their last success was at Goodison Park in mid-September. Everton are again the opponents when Robbo's men finally end that sequence on Boxing Day.
Hignett in space, and Hignett has scored! Craig Hignett with 22 minutes played, beautifully found by Emerson. Slid into his path and passed into the net by Craig Hignett. Speech cross, hung up towards Ferguson. There was a hand there, it was Derry White, I think. A penalty's been given. Well, he was in a crowd with Ferguson and Branch, but only he will know why. And Unsworth has scored for Everton, and it's 1-1. Ravanelli. Blackmore, going for the curl, he's got it! Oh, welcome back. Clayton Blackmore marks his return to the team with a stunning goal. Curl past his Welsh international colleague Neville Southall. Barnby. Ferguson had to do. Well, there's a certain inevitability when Duncan Ferguson is given that amount of space to pick his place with a header. Everson has Juninho to his right, running free. Now running at Unsworth. Juninho, blocked by Barrett. Ravanelli's there. Juninho's there. It's 3-2 to Middlesbrough. Juninho caps his return to the side with a goal which gives Boro the edge again. It's the third time in the match they've been in front. Juninho's initial effort blocked by Barrett. Allen couldn't get it clear, and Juninho buried it. Back out to Juninho. Everton backing off him, giving him every respect. Ravanelli, it's Juninho, it's four! And that should be the long-awaited Boro victory. Juninho and Ravanelli combine to get a fourth with just over 15 minutes left to play. Ravanelli may be offside. Juninho off balance, somehow squeeze it in.
I know that if we can get just a little bit more solid at the back and give us a platform to work from, then I know that we're always going to create and score goals with the type of lads we've got in the team.
How much of a relief is this victory?
Well, it is a relief because you always want to win football matches, but I think what it's going to do this game is just give our lads that confidence and the belief back again. And what we've got to do, we've got to build on this performance.
The Boxing Day celebrations are followed by the start of another worrying run at Coventry. The final match of 96 begins with an opening goal by Darren Huckerby inside the first half hour. Boro's best chance was denied by the woodwork. Chris Morris served up a teasing cross, and Ravanelli cursed his luck when his diving header came back off the upright. The Sky Blues made certain of extending their three-match winning run that lifted them off the bottom of the table in the second half. Gary McAllister made it 2-0 from the penalty spot after Steve Vickers had brought down Huckerby. Then, 5 minutes from time, Neil Cott completed another day of disaster when he smashed home a spectacular own goal. 3-0, the final margin of defeat. The new year began with a tough test against Arsenal at Highbury. Boro's continuing injury crisis meant a rare start for player boss Brian Robson.
Away he goes right. Will he get there? Bergkamp! That is a fantastic finish from Dennis Bergkamp. Real class. Looking for Parler. Wright's in and Wright scores. Ian Wright, a defensive error, makes it 2-0 to Arsenal. Is that the 3 points for the Gunners on New Year's Day? It's Ravanelli against Lukic. And Ravanelli hits the crossbar. And it goes over. And that could be Middlesbrough's chance of getting back into the game gone.
In round 3 of the FA Cup, injury ruled Juninho out of the home tie with third division Chester. But bang on cue, Boro bounce back to their best form.
Header in, off the bar, Ravanelli! Ravanelli, teeing it up. Chance here, 2-0! Ravanelli! 3-0! Ravanelli! 4-0! Chance here for Beck. Stan calling for it on far post. Emerson going all the way. Look at this. Oh, the cheek of the man, and it's there. 6-0 the scoreline.
It's nice to have won again. The lads seem to be saving all the goals for the cup competitions at the moment. But I thought they went about it professionally, and once we scored the first goal, they settled down, and it was a decent performance. The only thing that I'm disappointed about is the bookings and the sending off.
Once again, the Cup brings the best out of Boro, and the big week continues with the Coca-Cola quarter-final against Liverpool. Boro are boosted by the return of Janino.
This is Hignett. And he's done it! Craig Hignett! A poor clearance by David James. And Hignett, well, he picked the ball up, but he still had plenty to do. But he rifled that shot past James. I was saying earlier, pulling in the toucan. That was a flat with the feet there. What a wonderful finish from Hignett. He's a 26-year-old former Anfield apprentice. Oh, lovely. Steve Vickers. Derek White has come up. That is Vickers! And Boro have two! James may have been beaten by the bounce, but Vickers struck it superbly. 27 minutes gone, it was a good corner. And Vickers met it sweetly. James really only saw it once it was past him. Sweet strike, and there's the reaction from Brian Robson. Here goes Fowler. Good save, Walsh. Almost an ironic cheer from the Boro fans. Bergo, McManaman screaming for it. He gets it, and he puts it away. Steve McManaman. Liverpool back in it. Oh dear, oh dear, and it could be Fabrizio Ravanelli. Too much excitement, and right, what was he thinking about?
Sweet revenge for Boro after their pre-Christmas thrashing at Anfield. The reward is a place in the semi-finals of the League Cup for the first time. A night for celebration on Teesside. After two brilliant cup wins, it was back to league duty at home to bottom club Southampton.
Turns in nicely. Can he find one of those blockbustering shots of his? Emerson trying to tee it up. Took too long about it though. Musto deflected. Great save. And Janino coming in there, just beaten to it by Taylor. What a great save there by Mike Taylor. Come on! Chance here. Southampton are in for the first. Great save by Walsh. Oh, he got his hand to it. Superb save to deny David Hughes. Cow trying to make space on the six-yard line. Victor Grumman, Cow with the header! Oh, and that's a penalty, and surely a sending off. Clayton Blackmore punched the ball over the bar, surely. Here it is again. Over it goes. In comes the shot from Moncow, and that's a penalty. But the referee still not clear. Oh, it's a red card, so Blackmore off. Jim Magilton then, four goals to his name this season. Can he beat Walsh from the penalty spot? 1-0 it is to Southampton. A bitter blow this to Middlesbrough. They go behind, they're reduced to 10 men. And a lot of work to be done here by Brian Robson's team.
Unfounded stories consistently appearing in the press which are causing this football club minor problems. We would rather that they didn't exist. The club reserves the right at this time to seek legal advice on what action it will take both against the Mirror and against the Mail. We would ask that both of them publications consider retracting the story. It is untrue, it is unfounded, it slanders the name of Brian Robson and it slanders the good name of Middlesbrough Football Club. And that's it, thank you.
Boro's crash to the bottom of the table has given the headline writers more ammunition to write off Robbo's men. Boro respond by signing two new defenders. Vladimir Kinder, a £1 million buy from Slovan Bratislava, and Gianluca Festa arrives for £2.7 million from Inter Milan. Without a ball being kicked, Boro find themselves further adrift at the bottom of the table. The Premier League have decided to dock 3 points for Boro's no-show at Blackburn. It leaves Boro 4 points behind Southampton. Boro respond in stirring fashion at home to Sheffield Wednesday.
Ravanelli. Good ball in from Ravanelli. With the corner kick. Beck right on the goal line. Here he is with the header. Oh, 2-0! Oh, what a debut! What a debut for this man! 22 minutes of English football behind him, and he's on the score sheet. It's Middlesbrough 2, Sheffield Wednesday 0. And the fans are delighted. Humphries on the run. Oh, and Humphries has ridden the challenge, a chance here. Good block first, chance for 2-1. Brilliantly taken by Mark Pembridge. That was good work by Janinho as well, just put the boot in on the ball. Well, Viv Anderson having a word with the official now because the flag is just going up all the time. Ravanelli goes. Oh, desperate stuff here. The second week running that Middlesbrough have had a player sent off. And Ravanelli fuming at the assistant referee. Beck's in the middle. Can he get the cross in? Oh, Des Walker there with a clearance. And that's a penalty. Yes, that is given. Pressman brings down Beck. Des Walker didn't make the clearance properly. Beck jumped in on the situation. I think you'll clearly see this. Des Walker there, he didn't get the ball away. In goes Beck, and there's a foul. Yes. Well, a question mark there, because there were lots of bodies in the penalty area before the ball was struck. Blinker again. Good ball in from him. Pembridge is there, and he scored! Gets his second of the afternoon. Emerson to Janinho. Can he get the cross in? Bamboozles are Nolan. Oh, there it is! Put that one in the album. A great goal by Janinho. He sent them this way on that and filled the ball low past Kevin Pressman. It's 3 points for Middlesbrough.
Janinho's final strike in the dying minutes ensures Boro end Wednesday's 13-match unbeaten run. Next, it's back to the Cup and a fourth-round tie against non-league Hensford. And the part-timers give Middlesbrough's millionaires a fright.
Ben Roberts really hasn't been called upon to do much so far, but it could be here. O'Connor's through! Oh, and it's 1-0 to Hensford! 14th minute of the game, and Joe O'Connor scores his 221st goal for Hensford Town and puts the Vauxhall Conference side into the lead. Ravanelli poised to come in on the far post. Beck just behind him. Oh, and he's there! Beck will claim it. Janino's corner kick headed in the 25th minute. And Middlesbrough of the Premiership being held by Hensford Town. Fiatov! Oh, he scored! That surely is the winner! Great shot from Fiatov. How about that? That's the guy who scored it. Who wants my shirt? It's Middlesbrough 2, Hensford Town 1. Emerson, he's got a little bit of space here. Works it on the left foot, drills it across, Ravanelli! It's all over now! 3-1, Ravanelli! His 20th goal of the season. McNally's cross, that's not a bad ball! Oh, that's a great goal! O'Connor again! That's a great ball from McNally!
What is great about this competition, all teams in England can go to Wembley and they can win the FA Cup. In other countries, you will start with a second or third division team, but here everyone could be in. I mean, headness for is what a cup is all about, although it's easy to say that now after the game when we're through.
5 days later, Fjortoft is on his way to Sheffield United for £700,000. Meanwhile, suspended Ravanelli misses the match at Selhurst Park.
Finally beaten away by Vickers, but Gale goes outside. Vickers, yes! Wimbledon take the lead. Janino. Stamp to Janino. Oh, it's delightful. He's come more and more into the match, Janino, as it's progressed. Beck, back to Janino. Will he get there? Musto equalises. But Janino will milk the credit.
Musto's equaliser extends Boro's unbeaten run to 3 matches. Another yellow card for Emerson means he's ruled out of the FA Cup tie at Main Road, but Ravanelli is back.
But he's found Vester on a forward run. Ravanelli. Fleming. Has it all taken too long? Janino! They couldn't keep the little genius in the bottle for 90 minutes. Janino with a goal to break Manchester City hearts.
Boro are now in the quarter-finals of the FA Cup and the semi-finals of the Coca-Cola Cup. The Twin Towers of Wembley beckon in both competitions. If only Robbo's men could have more luck in the Premiership.
Picnic was quicker off the mark, but it falls to Newcastle. Here's Ferdinand.
Oh, it's in. Les Ferdinand with a typically emphatic finish. Too long for Ravanelli, not too long for Mikael Beck. Wasted. If only he'd kept his head.
Costa
on by Vickers. Ravanelli! He's done it, but the referee has spotted something he didn't like. And much to Ravanelli's disgust and dismay, the goal has been ruled out.
The narrow defeat by Newcastle is followed by another move into the transfer market. Aussie goalkeeper Mark Sforza is signed from Bradford for £1.25 million. Sforza steps straight into the side for the Coca-Cola Cup semi-final against Stockport.
Still, Stockport are holding on. Team from the second division holding the team from the Premiership. 0-0 in this. But now Beck. The flag has stayed down. It's still with Beck. And it's a goal.
missed his kick. Beck's going through. Hignett's in here now. There's another chance for Middlesbrough. Ravanelli! Ravanelli!
Boro are just one short step away from their first major cup final at Wembley, but they're still walking a tightrope in the battle to stay in the Premiership. And survival continues to look precarious when Boro find themselves two goals down at Hillsborough. Andy Booth opens the scoring midway through the first half when he heads home Mark Penridge's pinpoint cross at the near post. It begins to look bleak when Wednesday make it 2-0 at half-time. Carboni supplies the ammunition and Graham Hyde pulls the trigger. Boro are given a lifeline when good work by Robbie Musto sets up an own goal midway through the second half. But the Owls claim the points at the death when Boro concede a penalty. Penbridge is on target to make the final score, Wednesday 3, Boro 1. 5 points adrift at the bottom of the table, Boro have now reached the point where they have to start fulfilling their full Premiership potential.
It's Paul McGrath. It's a good ball to Mikkel Beck. Applause around the Riverside Stadium. Emerson. Beck has made the run down the left. Dark and a run from Ravanelli. He and Steve match together. Ravanelli! Shouldn't have been, but it is, and he's made up for the error of the first half. For a break by Middlesbrough if Juninho plays it. Here's Ravanelli and Beck coming in from the other side. Should be four. And is.
Tonight, it was a very, very big game for us, probably the most important of this season. But it's 3 points, you know, it's not 10 points or 12 points, you know, it doesn't really get us out of trouble, but we're on our way there, and if we get the 3 points back off the FA, you know, what could happen, it could be a brilliant season.
3 days after their biggest win of the season, Boro have to start all over again against Derby in the quarter-finals of the FA Cup.
Juninho, brilliant play. Oh, Juninho for Middlesbrough, fabulous goal. Wonderful goal, the way it was made and taken by the little Brazilian. And Middlesbrough are in front. After 38 minutes. And you won't see a better goal, perhaps, in terms of build-up and execution in the FA Cup this weekend. If you do, you're very lucky. Juninho was the instigator, the architect, initially, got the return pass and then just pushed the ball calmly past Martin Taylor as he came out. Goalkeeper could do nothing about that. And Juninho, who got the winner at Manchester City in round 5, has got the first goal at Derby in round 6. And Middlesbrough deserve it, really. They've made the better chances in the first half. Stamp, and now Ravanelli poised to make a run. This is Juninho. He's got nobody to his left. He has now. It's Ravanelli. The lovely switch of play. Oh, what a finish! And Ravanelli ensures that Middlesbrough will go into the FA Cup semi-final for the first time in their history. It's his 25th of the season, but this one has huge significance. Lovely switch of positions with Juninho, and Ravanelli rifles the ball with his left foot beyond Martin Taylor, and in stoppage time makes it Derby 0, Middlesbrough 2.
Borough are still bottom of the table, but incredibly remarkable Wembley double is still on the cards. Route 1 begins at home to Stockport in the Coca-Cola semi-finals. Borough leading 2-0 from the first leg, but nothing can be taken for granted against the competition's outstanding giant killers.
Bennett, who had such a terrific game, and is much waiting for it. So the skipper's going to take it. Running Armstrong, played in the game.
And a superb goal! And it's Connolly who scored it!
Ravanelli's made a terrific breakthrough the middle for him. Fleming's up there as well, Hignett's up there as well, but it's all Juninho at the moment. Hignett playing it on. Oh, and they've made it back there! And it's over the top! Juninho has missed a golden opportunity. And Middlesbrough can start making their Wembley preparations. They can indeed now. They've lost on the night, but they've won on aggregate. And Brian Robson's side goes to Wembley, the first time a Middlesbrough side has been in a major final.
An historic milestone to celebrate for the fans and a moment to savour for the players. Borough are on their way to their first major cup final at Wembley after 121 years of trying.
Yeah, I mean, it's tremendous for the club. I mean, the fans, they have not waited a long time for the club to go to a Wembley final, so it's a great night for them, even though we made hard work of it.
Yeah, at times it looked very difficult for you tonight against Stockport.
Yeah, I've said all along, I knew Stockport would.
That was Ravanelli. Oh.
Very important tonight, the match for Middlesbrough, for the players, for the supporters. Wembley, very, very, very nice.
I'm not.
This is dangerous.
There's a long way to go before it. There's a long way.
Concentrate,
oh. Shut up!
This time, Borough's cup joy is followed by a happy outcome in a league match.
Emerson battling it out there with Neil Lennon. Chance here for Blackmore. Good shot, good goal! Oh, my word! Clayton Blackmore, the Welsh international, really has been out of favour at Middlesbrough this season. But he shoots them into the lead in the 8.5 minutes of this game. It's proved this season, but a bad mistake there by Pryor. Chance here for Juninho! Oh! Would you believe it? Fleming. This is Beck. Juninho, he's wriggled through again! Can he finish this time? No, he can't! That's twice he's been through, and twice he's missed. He just opens up defenders as if they're not there. He wriggles one way, sways the other, but he just can't find the finish. Holding it up well, but misdirecting his ball. Oh, beautifully judged ball, that one. And Juninho's in, third time lucky, surely. Yes, it's 2-0. And Juninho hits his 11th goal of the season. An individual effort, that. He ran half the length of the field. But what a well-judged ball that was. From Emerson, beautifully played, he spotted in there, and really the defence at Tatters. Juninho, Hignett, and Clayton Blackmore through to Juninho again. Beck bursting to the left, good ball from Juninho. Beck's in, he must finish, he does. It's 3-0 to Middlesbrough. 35 minutes gone, Juninho inevitably had a hand in it. Beck finds the finish, his seventh goal of the season here, but it was a beautifully judged ball from Janino, straight at his feet. He controlled it well, kept his cool, and drilled his shot low past Kevin Poole. And Leicester City trail Middlesbrough by 3-0. Heads again, Parker won it well, but it falls to Janino, and that's a great ball for Emerson. Beautifully judged ball, Emerson on the charge here, and he can really fire him in, this fella. Looks for Ravanelli, and Ravanelli misses! And that's put Leicester City on the offensive. A chance here, Marshall battling for the header, and there's a goal! He just pushed Fleming away and headed into that far corner of the net.
It does beg the question, why are Middlesbrough bottom of the league?
I can't understand that question. I can understand too. So we are playing very well. So I think if we keep going, doing the same, we get up and save Middlesbrough that bad situation. I think we had a main problem, so problems with players injured, some players sick. We stayed without winning 11 games. It can't happen in the club like Middlesbrough. So we are concentration now in saving Middlesbrough.
Boro's fine form continued at home to Blackburn.
Builds. Good ball forward towards Fabrizio Ravanelli, right-hand edge of the Blackburn penalty area. Beck is up and wants the ball, so too Blackmore. Scored from a similar distance against Leicester, has another goal and hits the bar! That's a cracking good effort and the best of the night for Middlesbrough. 19 minutes gone. Janino from midway inside his own half, feed Fabrizio Ravanelli, and Middlesbrough for once have another bit of space in which to work. If Ravanelli looks up, he can find Stamp. Stamp does to Janino. Janino surely! And Janino breaks the deadlock! The spark of genius who are calling for is provided predictably by the Brazilian.
Emerson forward to Janino. Janino, this has got to be onside. Yes, it is. It's Ravanelli. It's one against one. And it's 2-0! Fabrizio Ravanelli, 26 goals this season. He did everything right, very similar to his goal. The first of his goals against Derby County. Took the ball from Janino, waited, and tucked it not just under the keeper, but between his legs. And that's Middlesbrough 2, Blackburn Rovers 0.
Quickly taken, short one. Oh, that's dangerous. Hignett tries to get a foot in. That's a good cross, and that's a good goal. It looks like Chris Sutton.
Mikel Beck to Janino. He's onside. Could this be the goal which Middlesbrough need to seal it? He cuts one way. He cuts another. That's an excellent save from Tim Flowers. That's great work from Janino. Then a fine one-handed save from a keeper who was once, I suppose still is, on the fringe of England duty.
Victory over Blackburn makes it 3 in a row in the Premiership. Boro's revival is gathering speed and confidence is high in the home match with Chelsea.
Twice, 11 and a half minutes into this game, and Chelsea survive. Oh my word, how did that ball not go in? Janino just waiting for the runners to move. Emerson, Janino. Great play by Janino, great ball too to Beck. Janino's inside for the return ball. Can Beck get it across? Janino with it! Oh my! Season, and it came from Janino. Good switch ball from Hignett. Janino popping up over on the far side this time. He's everywhere. Oh, just skips past Di Matteo. Oh, thunder
a shot coming in there from Juninho. And this is turning almost into the Juninho show.
Is there any danger that you're becoming a one-man team?
Well, I don't think so, because I think since Nigel Pearson came back in the team, we've done remarkably well as well. So it's not just down to Juninho. You know, Emerson's played his part, Gianluca Festa's played his part. I think they've all played the part. Since Christmas, I think we've put in some good performances and deservedly we're moving up that league.
The revival slows down in Boro's third match in 6 days when Forrest make an early breakthrough.
That's a good cross from Pearce. And Hoydon with a shot on the first save of the match. Should be a goal, it is a goal! Good ball by Fleming. Nobody could move into the space to collect. And a good jump and a good header from Nigel Pearson. Really solid in the centre there is Pearson. Blackmore working the 1-2. Good turn by him. Finds Juninho. Oh, that's a great ball. Brilliantly taken! Robson's made no move to bring on some fresh legs, but here's Clayton Blackmore looking for more. Oh!
The next big day for Boro is the bid to get 3 points reinstated. It's an anxious wait for manager Brian Robson.
I just think it was a very harsh decision in the first place. If you've got so many injuries within a football club, when I'm not talking six or seven, I mean I'm talking 23 injuries we had with the injury and illness. When you get to that, you've got to be seen to be showing common sense, and that's all I'm looking for to hear, and is that fairness will come across and common sense will prevail.
Do you think you'll get that?
I think we'll get a fair hearing, but what their decision's going to be at the end of the day we'll not know until Wednesday, but hopefully it'll be favourable for our club.
Ironically, what turned out to be a black day for Boro began with Robbo receiving the Manager of the Month award.
I'm delighted. I mean, this is a reward for the lads, the effort that they have put in this month, and that, you know, they've done tremendously well.
Does it have a slightly bittersweet taste today?
Well, it was nice when I found out about this morning. It was nice, but obviously we're disappointed about the appeal.
The Board of Appeal has considered all the submissions very carefully. It has dismissed the appeal of Middlesbrough on liability, taking the view that Middlesbrough was quite capable of fielding a team and that the club did not have just cause in cancelling the fixture. On penalty, the board accepts that Middlesbrough acted in good faith, but considers that the breach of the rules was serious. The board does not consider the award of the game to Blackburn practical or appropriate. The board considers that a deduction of 3 points and a fine of £50,000 is right and fair.
The feeling of injustice over 3 points denied was a cross to bear for Boro's supporters. Meanwhile, nothing can dampen the fans' excitement about a trip to Wembley. Unprecedented scenes became commonplace at the Selnet Riverside Stadium when the Boro faithful queued for tickets for the Coca-Cola Cup final.
You've got one of the first people to get a ticket this morning. How long have you had to wait to get a ticket?
Since Wednesday morning.
You've been here all that time?
Yeah. Sleeping, I want to go home and go to bed.
Is it worth it?
Yeah, worth it.
Let's have a look at your ticket then.
Have you ever been to Wembley Stadium before?
No, first time.
Well, he's going now. He's going now.
I've saved all the money for my paper round now.
Just to prove it's not just the chaps that queue up all night, how long have you been in here?
Since Tuesday.
It's been very cold and windy, no doubt.
Yep. Very cold, but it's worth it.
See, we'll see you at Wembley.
tell him, see you Wembley race.
The Wembley experience began on the eve of the cup final when fans made an early start to their weekend in London.
About 4 o'clock in Leicester Square today, and I'm not ashamed of that. I'm so proud this weekend to be a Boro fan in London. I've taken so many knocks over the last couple of years being a Boro fan. I wear my colours on my sleeve, and this weekend has been worth it.
Midnight in Trafalgar Square, and one of London's most famous sights has well and truly been painted red.
He's a gem.
Don't forget the link.
You've got so much talent.
Are you watching
the town.
Newcastle?
The town is just an outrage mob. They love it.
It's midnight, girls. You're in Trafalgar Square. Aren't you supposed to be in your hotel rooms, you know, sleeping, ready for the big day?
This is the place to be.
Yeah, definitely.
Why?
Well, if you're a Boro fan, this is where you're supposed to be.
All the supporters singing, dancing.
The players' pre-match build-up was a little more relaxed.
Any time now.
You can hit.
It's a very good player. Excellent, excellent. It's not mad, though. Here's your tenner.
Go on.
What's that?
How much can you enjoy this?
Well, I enjoy it. I mean, this is what it's all about. It's far better being here and enjoying. So the few days that we've had at a beautiful hotel like this, preparing for a match as big as what we're going into, than sitting at home being knocked out of every competition in the early rounds. This is what it's all about.
You know, things will start building up from now to Wembley, and I'm very excited, obviously.
Nerves standard?
Not yet, no. I'm going to go for a walk and then have something to eat, and hopefully I won't be on the toilet too much.
Wembley had never seen anything like it. Boro fans adding their unique touch of style to the cup final experience, as well as plenty of passion.
We're in the Coldstream Guards, we've come all the way from Germany, watch this.
We can't believe it, you'll probably be back later in the year.
The atmosphere is unbelievable.
I've watched every game this season, mate, and I've enjoyed every single game, whether we've got beat or not. It's been fantastic. Watching the boys, Janino, Emerson, Ravanelli. It's a joy to watch a lot of them. It's fantastic. It's fantastic. Worth every penny I tell you to pay for them. And that's that.
Middlesbrough at Wembley and Father Christmas as well. It must be dreaming.
No, we're not dreaming because we've come down for one special mission. We go, we conquer, we come back at 10-5 with a cup.
Yeah!
We go back to sleep. Come back for the FA Cup. We're down twice this year.
Three times. Charity Shield.
And the FA Cup. And you call a Cola Cup tonight.
Yeah! And tell John Sadler with a round.
For the fans and the players, of course, this was a dream come true. Boro's first cup final experience in 121 years. A wonderful sight at the famous old stadium. A great day to say I was there. A proud moment for Brian Robson and his team.
Driven along the ground, Grayson had trouble getting that clear. Oh, that's a try!
to great rest of concentration. They're a little sloppy all round. And that's what we talk about. It's a great run across the front of the defender from Ravanelli. He did it 99% right. Nice little glancing header. He thinks it's just going to hit the post and go in. Not this time, it's not.
And Grayson caught in possession by Beck. Ravanelli's got a check here, otherwise he'd have been offside. But Beck now looks for him and finds him! What a chance for Ravanelli.
Well, you won't get a better opportunity in a cup final to make yourself an absolute hero than this. It's a great ball in from Beck. He delivers it first time. It's perfect. Go on, just hit it with power. He hits it straight at Casey Keller. That's the chance of this cup final, without a doubt.
Ravanelli tried to get it back to him. Juninho struggling his way through somehow. Ravanelli!
I think next time we have to be more careful and play. We play well, both teams play well, do very hard game. But when we scored the first goal, we had too much space for score the second goal. We didn't. So next game we have to look that.
The lads are disappointed, but they'll get up and train tomorrow morning and they'll get their heads on for Wednesday because we know how an important game that is.
Vickers. Well, it might turn into an excellent ball from Vickers. Juninho. Right foot, Juninho. It took a deflection. Hartson to run at Vickers. Oh, Hartson. Hartson stretches. Super save by Schwarzer.
At this stage of the season, every match is a big one. Next, it's an FA Cup semi-final against Chesterfield. A true David and Goliath contest that provides one of the most dramatic semi-finals ever.
To take it, and Middlesbrough, who looked down and out, 2-0 down, are back at 2-2, and they've done it with 10 men. Juninho teasing and taunting again. Ravanelli. Cross. Very good early cross. Hewitt! Jamie Hewitt! The lad from Chesterfield has equalised!
In the end, Boro's brave 10 men denied by the underdogs, but Robbo's men are delighted to earn a second chance. Meanwhile, it's back to the Coca-Cola Cup final and the rematch with Leicester City at Hillsborough.
That's good build-up play. And that's a great effort by Hignett.
That's it.
Now Juninho. Skips past challenges and delivers a brilliant ball forward for Hignett. Ravanelli is with him. It's a good challenge by Walsh, but he's there again. Juninho! Oh, if he'd have caught that right, Gallo would surely have been beaten, but praise to the American goalkeeper for his positioning and agility. Now the referee has waved play on here. Lennon, Heskey, chance for Heskey! Would you believe it? It hit the inside of the post, and this time it didn't go in. It's a player who looks tired in the kick-ins, but... just got that air about him, but here he is, and he's done it! Clarence has scored for Leicester! Kinder, Musto, and Kinder again. This is Emerson. What a lovely little ball, Emerson! Great save! Should have been 1-1.
A heartbreaking disappointment. At least there's still a second chance in the FA Cup, but the shattered Boro players know they had their chance to win a major trophy and let it slip away. Meanwhile, there's no rest for Boro. A crucial Premiership showdown with rival Sunderland follows 3 days later.
Foster. And Beck could be clear. Defenders trailing in his wake. It's Mikael Beck, and it hit the post. Beck did everything right and was denied by the upright. Now what can he conjure? Williams! Darren Williams for Sunderland! Against his hometown club, and who should set it up but the man bought to bring a few goals and to bring some guile to a struggling side, Chris Waddle. Oh, well, it's mugged by Juninho. And now the break's on, it's Beck. Look at a bit of shirt pulling. And was that a hand that was used by Bracewell? Apparently not. Juninho, still he's going. Beck with a clear chance.
A shattering setback for Boro's survival hopes. Robbo's men miss their chance to move out of the bottom three and concede valuable ground to Sunderland. Meanwhile, the FA Cup distraction continues with a semi-final replay against Chesterfield.
Juninho again against the mass ranks of Chesterfield, but he's found the pass for Beck, and Mikael Beck has given Middlesbrough the lead in the 12th minute. Coming alive again. Juninho wants the ball played to him. Ravanelli spots out Emerson! Well, what a way to round it all off.
Boro are on their way back to Wembley in style. Meanwhile, Robbo's men have five matches to save themselves from the nightmare of relegation.
Oh, and a chance here at the far post, and a great save, and it's in!
A brave effort by Boro's tired players ends empty-handed. There's now no margin for error.
The FA Cup will take care of itself. We spoke about that this week. This is the big one. If we can get points today, 3 points today, it gives us closer to the pack, and... set us up confidently for the next running of the next three games in the league.
What do you think you need, 40 points?
Well, the manager spoke about, and the people at the club have spoke about 40 points. I reckon 40 might be enough. 40, 41 will be enough. But we've just got to concentrate and get three today, and then the other games will take care of themselves.
Four games in 9 days will determine Boro's future. Nothing short of victory will do against Villa.
Hignett. Good ball over the top for Ravanelli. Left foot, 1-0. Oh, superb ball from Hignett. 19 minutes gone. It's Middlesbrough 1, Aston Villa 0. And that's his 30th goal of the season. Dwight York, great save by Roberts. Oh, that was a thunderous shot. And Ben Roberts sprang like a cat to his right. Hignett, Emerson. This is Fleming. Looking to get Beck away. That's a good ball. Can Beck do it? Oh, he's beaten Bosnic. 2-0. Superb ball by Fleming. 32 minutes gone. And Mikael Beck makes it. Boro 2, Aston Villa 0. Ball into Milosevic. They mustn't let him dribble his way through. Here's York! Oh! Superb save again. Over comes the corner. Ekiog getting up high. Oh, off the woodwork! Is it going to be Middlesbrough's day? Fester beaten in the air there by Ekiog. Oh, and it's there! The big man blasts it in. Stamp again, stretching, not controlling it. Oh, that's a great ball over the top to Milosevic. Chance to make it 2-2, and he has! Oh, my word! Middlesbrough's season is crumbling before them. Emerson! Wasn't kicked off the line there. Dwight York was there, Ekiog was there. Plays it inside to Hignett. Hignett getting into the box. That's a penalty! Oh, a chance of salvation here. Well, I tell you what, I wouldn't swap boots with the man who's going to take it, because the whole season could hinge on this 12-yard shot. I wonder how cool Ravanelli feels. This could be the difference between Premiership football next season and the First Division. Ravanelli then, tense times for him, up against Oakes. Oh, it's there! It's second of the match! It's Boro 3! Aston Villa 2! And we're 39:40 into stoppage time.
Well, they're delighted to get 3 points and just get on the winning way again today. But they're up for the challenge. You know, we know we've got three away games, but I think sometimes when you go into away games, you know, you maybe relax a bit more, and you're not as nervous about the position that you're in, and you maybe play a bit better football. So I'm just hoping that my lads react that way.
After the drama against Villa, Boro need another miracle at Old Trafford, just 48 hours later. United need victory to claim the title, but it's Boro who set the pace in a thrilling contest.
Ravanelli. Juninho getting the better of May, and it's Hignett. Back for Juninho. Chance for Middlesbrough. A goal.
What a goal.
For Brian Robson's men.
What a goal.
Solskjaer. Emerson! They're back in front!
Well, would you believe this game? What a touch from the substitute! Well,
promised excitement this afternoon, and I think we're getting plenty of that.
Yes! Yes!
Priester, another little great piece of interplay with Stamp this time. Middlesbrough want more. Robbie Musto. And it is more! Hignett! Key. Good climb by Pearson. Cole. Cantona. Gary Neville looking for his first goal for Manchester United. And what a time to get it! Oh, Winston, he chose Hignett as run forward, and Hignett's not going to have a run with him.
Boro denied by United's second-half fight-back is another story of what might have been. And the pain of defeat is made worse by the first-half injury to Ravanelli, who will miss the final two league matches. Meanwhile, Boro now know they need to win at least one of those matches. Next stop is Ewood Park for the rearranged fixture, which has already cost Boro 3 points. With Blackburn still in the relegation dogfight, this is a nail-biting contest.
Janino. And the referee says no. It was a somewhat injudicious challenge by Hendry, and he's not too impressed with the reaction taken by Janino. But he stretched for that, did the big defender. Ball was a bit late.
Well, Janino certainly got the ball first.
Emerson. Janino to his left, Beck to his right. Janino! Good save, Jim Flowers!
Frustrated, Boro are convinced they should have had a second-half penalty. But a point apiece means Blackburn have escaped, and Boro must sweat it out on the final day at Leeds.
And this is Stamp, and that's a good try! And Nigel Martin, the goalkeeper, very much in form. He's had a terrific season, the supporters' player of the year here at Leeds. Great hand it over.
Straight above him helps, of course. You wouldn't expect Martin to be beaten.
Janino, through for Beck! Martin Parris.
Oh, that's a great chance.
Willis with the cross, Brian Dean is free! It's a goal for Leeds United, and that might spell the end for Middlesbrough. Brian Dean's header. Brian Robson has to take it on the chin. Here is the invention, perhaps. Janino, well, there's still a chance.
It took a wicked deflection this, Martin. I think we'll find to beat Nigel Martin. It's no surprise that it's Janino who gets him back in. I thought he was a couple of yards offside. He certainly looked at it. As he ducks inside there, I think it flicks off Harrah. And it's just enough to take it wide of Martin into the corner.
Well, now we know. Really back you feel for Sunderland. One more goal. Safe, it's as simple as that. Wallace. There is no last day miracle for Middlesbrough. They had to win at Elland Road, and for all the efforts of Janino, Brian Robson's side couldn't do that. They went a goal down to Brian Dean's header. Janino's deflected shot gave them renewed hope. The draw, not enough. Next Saturday's FA Cup finalists will spend next season in Division One, desperate for all at the club, especially the manager, who brought them up as champions 2 seasons ago, guided them to 2 cup finals this season, and made such ambitious signings from overseas.
We've given it our best effort this week, and in the 4 games we're unbeaten. It's a bit difficult to take, but, you know, certainly with what's happened this year in terms of the press situation, you know, the flak we've taken, it would have been nice to have come out of it the last hurdle, but not to be. So I don't know what's going to happen now, but I think the best just leave to the players to in their own thoughts now. Difficult for us.
24 hours later, Boro's shattered team were given the chance to drown their sorrows at the Selnet Player of the Year awards night. The pain of relegation would not go away, but Boro had 6 days to pick themselves up for the FA Cup final. The star of the night was Juninho, winner of three awards.
He's nice, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, when they talk about landslides, the real landslide goes to Juninho.
Game Saturday, of course, but it's most important was he stay in the Premier. So that's gone, and we have to think now in the next game Saturday, because we had a great season, and Saturday we have a chance to prove in the pit that we are very good team. We are a better team than a lot that stay in the Premier League.
And so to the final chapter of Boro's historic season, the FA Cup final at Wembley. Another day out for the fans, determined not to let anyone forget about those precious 3 points.
A lot of nerves, it'll be even worse when we kick off. The players can go and run it off, I can't, neither can the supporters. But it's a great end to a dramatic season, and all of the emotions that we've suffered, and I hope that we can pull this off for the fans.
Players, this was the big one, the FA Cup final, a massive worldwide stage for Boro's superstars. The final chance to end the rollercoaster season with something special. With Ruud Gullit's Chelsea boasting their own exciting blend of foreign imports, expectations were high for a mouth-watering contest between two entertaining sides. Sadly, it just wasn't to be.
Robbie Musto battling with Dennis Wise. Now the first sign of Chelsea on the attack with Di Matteo. Oh, and a good run up front by Hughes, and Di Matteo shoots! Oh, what about this? What about this? It's possibly the quickest ever goal in a Wembley Cup final. It's Roberto Di Matteo inside 45 seconds. An unbelievable start by Chelsea. It went over his head to Festa, and now it's going to come out to Stant. Back in towards Festa with the header. The whistle's gone, offside. It won't count. The linesman on the far side is flagging. Brian Robson's team have not equalised. And Chelsea come away again with Newton. Petrescu is to the right, so is Hughes. This is Petrescu, and he's gone for the far corner, and Zola came in, and it's there! It's Eddie Newton. It's Eddie Newton for Chelsea. It's 2-0. And it looks like Chelsea's cup now.
The final nightmare for Boro's weary players. After giving so much in a marathon season, this was a cruel way for it all to end. No one had battled harder than Boro's brilliant Brazilian hero, Juninho, and Boro's heartbroken fans feared that this would be their final sight of the Brazilian genius in the Middlesbrough shirt.
Final word is that if we hadn't been deducted 3 points, we'd have finished 13th or 14th in the Premiership. And because of that, it'd have been a different attitude today. The town would be buzzing. You wouldn't be talking about Juninho staying or going. And the 3 points, if that stands, is going to be very, very costly to Middlesbrough Football Club. And I think that's a disappointing. To pick yourselves up from that from last week is difficult. They did look tired, but saying that, we'll regroup and take it from there.
A marathon season lasting 54 matches was finally over. A staggering 16 cup ties, including two Wembley finals, had ended without a trophy. And 3 points deducted by the FA meant the end of life in the Premiership. Nonetheless, Boro fans gave Brown Robson and his players a hero's reception on their return to Teesside. Whatever the consequences, this was a magnificent season in so many ways. Boro agonisingly close to a successful conclusion in all three competitions, but undeterred in the fight to bring glory to Teesside.
The players are really down because they know they had three challenges and they were so close to achieving, but it wasn't to be. But when they get support like that, then, you know, it makes it all worthwhile. You know, the fans have done their bit. We couldn't have asked anything more from them. I think we just need a little bit of lady luck. If we'd had a bit of lady luck, then things might have went better in the season. Unfortunately, it didn't go like that for us. But that's football, and what you've got to do is you pick yourself up and you have a few weeks on the beach moping about because of the disappointments, but then you get on with life again next season and you rise to the challenge and you try to succeed the next time round.
There's been many highs and there's been many lows. I think that perhaps the biggest low for me, the two biggest lows, was Chelsea's first goal after 45 seconds. It was like being shot, and perhaps the most difficult was the Leicester goal in the last 2 minutes at Wembley.
And a final word for the fans, what can you tell them across the summer?
We're very hungry for success, we'll continue to chase it. I know the talents here within the football club to produce it. We need to improve the team and we will continue to do so.
The players couldn't have wished for any better support from any supporters in this country, and I can guarantee you that. Because I've played for one of the best clubs, but I tell you what, your support has been fantastic this season. We would all just like to say to you, we are really disappointed as a set of players that we haven't rewarded you with just a little bit more. I know we've gone to a couple of cup finals and everybody has loved that because this club in 100 and odd years has never achieved that. But these players really wanted to win something for you and it just wasn't to be. But we did get close and I hope you all enjoyed the day. And what's more important than anything, as far as I am concerned, I hope you have all enjoyed the type of football that these players have played for you this season. Thank you.